once there was a tree, and she loved a little boy. And every day the boy would come, and he would gather her leaves and make them into crowns and play kick the forest. He would climb up her tree and drink from her branch and eat apples. And they will play hide and go seek. And when he was tired, he would sleep in her shade. And the boy loved the tree very much. And the tree was happy. But time went by. And the boy grew old. And the tree often alone. Then one day, the boy came to the tree. And the tree said, "Come, boy, come and climb up my trunk and swing from my branch and eat apples and play in my shade and be happy. I am too big to climb and play," said the boy. "I want to buy things and have fun. And I want some money. Can you give me some money?" "I'm sorry," said the tree, "but I have no money. I have only leaves and apples. Take my apples, boy, and sell them in the city. Then you will have money, and you will be happy." And so the boy climbed up the tree and gathered her apples and carried them away. And the tree was happy. But the boy stayed away for a long time, and the tree was sad. And then one day, the boy came back, and the tree shook it with joy, and she said, "Come, boy, climb up my trunk and swing from my branch and be happy. I'm too busy to climb up trees." Said the boy, "I want a house to keep me warm." He said, I want a wife and I want children. So I need a house. Can you give me a house?" "I have no house," said the tree. "The forest is my house." "But you may cut off my branch and build a house. Then you will be happy." And so the boy cut off her branch and carried them away to build a house. And the tree was happy. But the boy stayed away for a long time, and when he came back, the tree was so happy she could hardly speak. "Come, boy," she said. "Come, boy," she said. What she was. He whispered, "Come and play. I am too old and sad to play," said the boy. "I want a boat." I want a boat that death will take me far away from here. Can you give me a boat? I cut down my trunk and make a boat," said the tree. "Then you can sail away and be happy." And so the boy cut off her trunk and make a boat and sail away. And the tree was happy, but not really. And after a long time, the boy came back. The boy came back again. "I am sorry, boy," said the tree, "but I have nothing left to give you. My apples are gone. My teeth are too weak for apples," said the boy. My branches are gone," said the tree. "You can't swing on them. I am too old to swing on branches," said the boy. My trunk is gone," said the tree. "You can't climb. I am too tired to climb," said the boy. "I am sorry," said the tree. I wish I could, but I have nothing left. I am just an old stump. I am sorry. I don't need very much now," I said the boy. I just a quiet place to sit and rest. I am very tired. Well," said the tree, struck herself up.
Straightening
herself up. much as she could. Well, an old stump is good for sitting and resting. Come, boy, sit down. Sit down and rest. And the boy did. And the tree was happy. The end.
So who is the tree?
The stump.
What do you think?
Why the tree? Give me tree.
Why the tree give the boy everything?
Because he want money, a house, a boat.
But why is he give it to him?
To be nice.
Just nice?
Yeah.
You be nice, will you give your friend everything?
No.
So, more than nice, right?
Yes.
So did the bee tell you what the tree represent?
To call the giving tree.
The tree is actually a mom.
Yeah.
Does the bee tell you that?
Yes.
The author say that it's a tree, but she actually the boy mom.
The boy's mom.
And the mom would love her boy so much that she will give her boy everything. Okay, good job.
Good job.